Jessica Parker copy of said script. You can make out names such as Goldenblatt and Brady, among others. So I'm guessing Harry, possibly Lily, possibly Rose, definitely Charlotte, Steve, and Brady and Miranda are all included in this pilot episode of And Just Like That. It's most likely going to be a catch-up episode about, like, where are they now after some 12 plus years that we've not seen these characters. And it is not lost on me that the title is also an Adele lyric, perhaps teasing that we're on the other side of an emotionally dramatic time in Carrie's life, and that she's done some healing and is ready to come back into the world. So now let's turn our attention to the leaked page of the script. I can see that this is episode 2, and it's titled, Where Is She? It's page 7, and it is the copy belonging to Charles Hunt. So who is this Charles Hunt, who either purposefully or accidentally, negligently left this script out for a fan or a paparazzo to snap a pic of? IMDb says that Charles Hunt is a New York born and based Emmy nominated sound mixer for both film and TV. In the past, he has worked on Mystic Pizza, The King of Staten Island, The Big Sick, Spike Lee's Do the Right Thing, Chappelle's Show, Kids, and Law and Order, among many others. So that just goes to show you that even veterans can make rookie mistakes. Maybe if he stopped leaving scripts out for anyone to see, he would be an Emmy Award winning sound mixer for film and TV. Boom. Roasted. Just kidding, Charles. You know I love you. At the top of the script, there's a gray box that's crossed out. I don't know if that means it's a deleted scene, or if the scene was already filmed and they're filming the part that's not crossed out, or if it just means that Charles Hunt doesn't have to worry about sound mixing the scene that's crossed out. So anyway, in the gray box, it says the following things. A character named Norman is covering his iPhone's mouthpiece while talking, and he says, in my experience, when people have unfinished business, they tend to throw money at it. Then a character named Gloria says,
Sorry, Miss Jones, your card's not accepted.
Well, that's not possible. Try it again.
Maybe I'm not making myself clear. Your card and you are not accepted here.
Samantha had messed with the wrong woman. Sandy Cranwell practically owned Manhattan, and she wanted Samantha off it.
Come on. Let's go.
Sandy Cranwell had done what any well-heeled socialite would do. She took out a social hit on Samantha. In 12 hours, Sam had gone from A-list to blacklist.
Or maybe they're at the table that's by the kitchens because it's COVID times and they have to social distance when they're eating indoors. So that is just a table that is 6 feet away from another table. And they just kind of had to space the tables out. And they just happened to be the one by the kitchens, by the door. And nothing is actually wrong with Carrie or Big's social standing. Maybe they're not vaccinated, and so the wait staff has put them far away from other people who are vaccinated. Maybe they forgot their masks because, I mean, Sarah Jessica Parker did say that COVID was going to be acknowledged, so maybe that's why they're at the table by the kitchens. Any one of those reasons having to do with COVID-related things. It doesn't say what time or what meal the Core 4 is enjoying, but Miranda is drinking a glass of Cabernet, so if it's brunch, that's weird. If it's lunch, not so weird. It says day, so we know it's not dinner. Then there's the following dialogue. Carrie. I was doing well. Wasn't I doing well before this? Miranda. Yes, you were. Charlotte. Remarkably well. Samantha. I've been very impressed. Okay, so what is the this that Carrie was doing so well before? Well, I think it was that piece of news where Norman says, in my experience, when people have unfinished business, they tend to throw money at it. So let's say she and Big are getting divorced, or they are already divorced. Then the unfinished business that Big is throwing money at is Carrie herself, which isn't really a terrible problem to have, but maybe she still has feelings for Big and doesn't want to be thought of by him as a problem, something to have money thrown at it to make it go away because she doesn't really want to go away from Big. And then let's say that Carrie and Big are not divorced or getting divorced. Maybe he's throwing money at Natasha.
Natasha, what a bullshit name. Totally.
Stupid.
That's complete bullshit.
We have seen Bridget Moynihan on set and even doing a scene with Sarah Jessica. We know that she is back. So maybe Natasha...
Nijinsky or whatever her name is.
Is the unfinished business that Big is throwing money at. And Carrie's upset by that because... she wants something for herself. If Big dies before her, or maybe she wants more shoes, but her shoe budget is smaller because Big is throwing money at the problem that is
Natasha. Natasha, when'd you stop calling her the idiot stick figure with no soul?
Whatever the reason, Big is potentially throwing money at Natasha.
Don't say her name to me. Don't you dare say her name to me.
He's kept it a secret from Carrie. And I don't know about you, but I would be upset if my spouse kept a secret like that from me. Especially considering his past. Speaking of Big's past, perhaps he and
the idiot stick figure with no soul
had or are having an affair. And so he's throwing money at her so that she doesn't tell anyone. He's giving her hush money and Carrie finds out. Number one, about the money, and number two, the reason for the hush money, aka the affair. So obviously she's upset. But you know what? You lose them like you get them, honey. But even if it's not hush money for an affair, it sounds like it might be spousal support. Either way, Carrie didn't know about it, and so yeah, she has every right to be upset and stunned. Maybe if Big and Natasha had an affair, They had a love child as a result. And so Big is giving her child support. And Gary finds out about that and the child. Oh, maybe Big gave Natasha herpes. And so Big is paying for her Valtrex for life. Herpes is a kind of unfinished business that you have to keep throwing money at. So first of all, I would be mad if I were Gary that Big never told me he had herpes. And secondly, why isn't Big paying for Carrie's Valtrex? And here is a theory that kills two birds with one stone. Big is in jail because he committed some sort of financial crime. Tax evasion, tax fraud, insider trading. Maybe he's a con man. Who knows? But him being in jail would make them lose social status and financial standing. And they would be pariahs in society now, in the society that they were in before this. So that would explain why they're at the cramped table by the kitchens. And then to explain the unfinished business that you are throwing money at, Natasha knew about it because he'd been doing it since they were married. And she found out about it, and that's actually why she left him. Not because he cheated on her with Carrie, but because she didn't want to possibly go to jail herself as an accessory to his crimes. And so Big was giving Natasha money to be quiet so that he didn't go to jail, but he was found out and caught anyway. He probably got sloppy. Oh my God, his name is John. John James Preston. He is Dirty John. Big is Dirty John. And then what was the thing that happened before the thing that she was doing so well after? And I think that was a couple of things. One of them was possibly Samantha's death. In which case, why would Carrie be more affected by Samantha's death than Samantha, Charlotte, or Miranda? Well, we know that Carrie was closer to Samantha than the other three, but that doesn't mean that the other three would just be like la-di-da, totally unaffected by Samantha's death. I think that they were close enough that they would be affected. Another thing is if Samantha died and Carrie is like putting herself in a more prominent place of grief than the other three, it's because that's a very Carrie thing to do. She's selfish and centers herself in conversations and feels like her grief or her life or her drama or her misfortune, whatever, is more important than anyone else's. She interrupts, she steamrolls. She gives people 5 minutes to talk about themselves and then takes 30 minutes to talk about herself. So Carrie hasn't really changed or grown in the last 12 years. She's 50 going on 15 and still doesn't believe in or go to therapy. What else could she have been doing so well with before Norman spilled the beans? Okay, maybe she was doing so well with her and Big's divorce, but that's not likely, unless maybe the divorce was so amicable till she found out that some of what she might be getting from Big, he had been giving to Natasha. That's very selfish, which I wouldn't entirely put that past Carrie, but maybe she's just been doing very poorly financially, hence the having to sit at the table by the kitchen, and so only getting $1 when she could get 12 is hitting a little too close to home right now. And now this is the theory that I think is the most likely, and that is that Big is dead. That is why everyone at the table is so impressed with how well she's been doing. She's been doing well since Big died, until she found something out, until Norman spills the beans. Until what exactly? Well, I've already touched on that a little bit, but I'll touch on that a little bit more after I continue on with the script, with the following dialogue. Carrie, I mean, I was doing the podcast. I was washing my hair. Yes, I wasn't eating or sleeping, but at least I felt good about my marriage. Now I'm just one of the wives he was taking care of. First of all, we find out that Carrie has a podcast or is a frequent guest on someone else's podcast. Maybe her podcast is called Sex and the City. Maybe her podcast is called And Just Like That, hence the name of the series. Or maybe her podcast is called 50 Shades of Grey, and it deals with the topic of middle age, like coming to terms with aging, your body, your hair, your skin, menopause, your sex life in your 50s, how things are no longer black and white, how if you're in your 50s, you are Gen X, and so you kind of have to come to terms with millennials and Gen Z and everything those generations represent that you may not. Then we learn that Carrie is washing her hair, but she is not eating or sleeping. Her priorities are all messed up, and she doesn't know the threes of survival. What is it? You can survive 3 minutes without air, 3 hours in extreme heat or cold, 3 days without water, 3 days without washing your hair, 3 days without sleeping, 3 weeks without food, and 3 seconds without checking your phone. Okay, so why isn't Carrie eating or sleeping? Possibility number one, she's sad about Samantha dying. And she can be sad about Samantha dying and still feel good about her marriage until Norman spills the beans. Number two, she's sad about her divorce. She can be sad about her divorce and still feel good about her marriage if the divorce is amicable until she finds something out by Norman spilling the beans. She's sad about Big being in jail. She can be sad about Big being in jail and still feel good about her marriage until Norman spills the beans. Possibility number four, and this one comes with a trigger warning. Carrie became pregnant and had a miscarriage. So she was sad about the miscarriage, but still felt good about her marriage until Norman spilled the beans. This actually could be a thing because the show has explored women becoming pregnant in their 50s before with Bitsy Von Muffling, who just so happens to be a returning character in this series. She's coming back for And Just Like That. It was announced a couple of days ago, so this is not too far-fetched. Maybe Carrie will seek advice from Bitsy Von Muffling and become pregnant by doing what Bitsy Von Muffling did to become pregnant in her 50s, and then unfortunately lose the baby, and that's what causes trouble with Big and Carrie's marriage. Chris Noth did say that he would not come back and do this series if it was just gonna be candy canes and rainbows. He wanted real life tough stuff and miscarriages that also then go on to cause trouble in the marriage. That's pretty real life tough stuff. And lastly, possibility number five, she's sad about Big being dead. She can be sad about Big being dead and still feel good about her marriage to him until Norman spills the beans. This is basically Norman spilling the beans. He has spilled so many beans. Okay, so to reiterate, I think that the beans that Norman has spilled are dollar beans, not lay dollar beans, but actual dollars, dollar bills, dollar beans, because he has let some of Big's financial dealings slip. So, if Big and Carrie are divorced or are getting divorced, if Samantha is dead, if Carrie had a miscarriage and that is causing some trouble in their marriage, or if Big is having an affair with Natasha, Carrie finds out that Big is giving support or hush money to Natasha. Or maybe spousal support to Natasha and Barbara. And that is why she says, I'm only one of the wives that he's taking care of. If Big is dead, which I think is the most likely, then Carrie finds out that Big had been giving spousal support to Barbara and or Natasha. And since he's deceased, Carrie found that out. And now she has to decide whether or not the spousal support is going to stop or continue. Maybe Norman lets it slip that if Big is dead, he left something to Barbara and or Natasha in his will, such as a great sum of money or property. And Carrie was doing okay until she found that out. After Carrie finishes speaking, the comedic relief comes in the form of Samantha's chair getting hit hard by the kitchen door. Then Samantha says, ow, worst four top ever. Then Carrie says, let me switch seats with you. I'm used to getting slammed from behind. I'm guessing that's in reference to the news that she just found out from Norman. Then Miranda says, no one's changing seats. Then she looks at the server and says, hi, yes, hi. Could you be more careful? You keep hitting his seat. And can I get another glass of Cabernet? Thanks. So from this, I'm going to comment about how Miranda has finished her Cabernet very quickly and is asking for another one. This is how I imagine it went down. So I wonder if in this new series, Miranda has an alcohol problem. Did she develop one in the last 12 years? Did Samantha's death make her an alcoholic? Will Miranda attend Alcoholics Anonymous meetings where she may run into Patrick? Maybe he'll be Miranda's sponsor. Let's just hope he's wearing his clothes. And that's all I've got for now for this super extensive analysis of the leaked and just like that script page. If you're still watching this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and I will see you next time. I've gotta go find Charles Hunt. I need a sound mixer for this video because I just realized you can hear my AC in the background almost the entire time. I'm really sorry about that, but I'm not sweaty. And just like that, this video is over.
So over. We need a new word for over.